since he took office.
But he does admit there's a long way to go, now calling on businesses to help get the job done. The president's senior policy advisor is talking with NBC2 chief political correspondent Dave Elias about the plan.
Well, Florida is still a ways from herd immunity. Today, the Biden administration announced incentives for companies to offer their employees to get the vaccine, like I'm about to get.
That'll complete your vaccine record.
As an employer, I know how difficult it is for my staff to take a day off to go and get vaccinated.
Sylvia Doresmi owns and operates the Zeal Technical Institute.
A lot of people who do want to get vaccinated, they work a full-time job. They don't have time. They can't afford to take a day off.
But she's making it easy for her employees.
Every single month, each employee gets one mental health day. And so we coordinated the schedule where they can take that mental health day to take care of themselves. And that is including taking the vaccines.
Most companies, though, don't do that. President Biden wants to change that.
No working American should lose a single dollar from their paycheck because they chose to fulfill their patriotic duty of getting vaccinated.
His senior policy advisor, Dr. Cameron Webb, tells me the plan calls for reimbursing businesses for vaccine-related paid time off.
We need to make sure that people have the opportunity to get vaccinated. We know that they now have enough vaccine.
But not enough incentive for everyone.
It wouldn't help change my mind. There just hasn't been enough time yet for me to see how it affects, especially women that want to get pregnant down the road.
Dr. Webb had this response.
And I had a patient just the other day who told me he doesn't necessarily trust everything about the vaccine, but he got vaccinated because his doctor told him to. And I think that you'll see that with trusted messengers.
The tax credit also reimburses employers $17,000 for 14 weeks of paid leave if an employee gets COVID or their child's school closes because of the pandemic.
And just like that, you could be one of the 24% in Florida who are now fully vaccinated. Dave Elias, NBC2.